One of my favorite things is watching how one thing leads to another in music. And this set of events, I think, is my favorite one of all time. It all starts in 1967 with a French song written by a guy named Claude François. It went like this. J'aime l'air et je te bouscule. Tu ne trouvais pas comme habitude. Sur toi, j'ai vraiment les droits. Je peux que tu aies froid comme habitude. Ma main caresse tes cheveux presque malgré moi comme d'habitude. Mais toi, tu mets ton lélo comme habitude. The central thing going on with this song is this bass line. And because of that, a bunch of English speaking people, set after trying to rewrite this song to see if they could make a hit for English-speaking audiences, too. It ended up on the desk of one British guy named Davy Jones. And Davy, although he was kind of a failing pop star at the time, was trying to make ends meet at this music publisher rewriting songs in English. He put out an album or two. He had to use a pseudonym, a stage name, because there was another, much more famous Davy Jones for the Monkees, and that wasn't him. So he put out a couple, but they hadn't sold yet, so this is what he was doing with his time. Anyway, he got the assignment, and he wrote some lyrics, and his went like this. There was a time, a laughing time, he took his heart to every party. They look his way. How are you today? Will you make us laugh? Chase our blues away. Our funny man won't let them down. No, he'll dance and prance and be their clown. That happy time, the laughing time, when even a fool learns to love. Well, that wasn't very good, actually. But he submitted it anyways. And then forgot about it. And I think it was about 1969. He turned on the radio and he hears this chord progression. But when the guy opens his mouth to start singing, he doesn't hear his lyrics. He hears this. Regrets, I've had a few. But then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do. And I saw it through without exemption. I've planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. But more, much more than this, I did it my way. Well, it turns out they didn't just send it to Davy, they sent it to Canada, to a guy named Paul Anka. He wrote My Way, and then promptly sold it to his buddy Frank Sinatra, which then became Frank's signature song. Now that is pretty cool, and that's where this should end, but it doesn't. What happened was Davy, for some reason, got irrationally mad. And so he took another crack at this song, and he wrote a song instead about a young girl who was not satisfied with her life, saw a different life, but couldn't access it and wanted to escape. Except for when Davy got to this part right here, instead of going back down around and around, he decided to go up. So he goes. And right there, right as the girl is imagining that she's going to escape this life, he does something pretty cool. He modulates. He changes the key. So one more time, he goes. Key change. So he put that, I think it was his third album, and on the back cover, where he put the title of this song, he put a little note that said, "To Frankie," which nobody really understood, but it's because this was his revenge song on that Frank Sinatra song. Anyway, that song went like this. It's a god-awful small affair. To the girl with the mousy hair, and her mommy is yelling no, and daddy has told her to go, and a friend is nowhere to be seen, as she walks through a sunken dream, to the seat with the clearest view. Now she's hooked to the silver screen, and the scene is of saddening bore, for she's seen it 10 times or more. She could spit in the eyes of fools as they ask her to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at them cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. Take a look at the low man beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, wonder if they'll ever know. In the best-selling show, is there life on Mars. On America's tortured brow, Mickey Mouse has grown up a cow. But the workers have struck for fame, 'cause Lenin's on sale again. And the mice with their million hordes, from Ibiza to the Norfolk Broads, Rue Britannia is out of bounds to my mother, my dog, and clowns. But the film is a saddening bore, for I've wrote it 10 times or more. It's about to be read again, as they ask me to focus on sailors fighting in the dance hall. Oh man, look at them cavemen go. It's the freakiest show. Take a look at the long man beating up the wrong guy. Oh man, I wonder if they'll ever know. It's the best-selling show. Is there life on Mars? That became Life on Mars from David Bowie's Hunky Dory album, which when you put that together with Ground Control to Major Tom, sets the stage for his next album, which becomes Ziggy Stardust, and the rest is history. All that from one French song in 1967. Frankie's biggest hit launches David Bowie. I love that.